Hello, fellow audio nerds. I'm Steph, and this is Major Hi-Fi. Today, I have with me the Audio-Technica ATH-ANC700BT. They're wireless, and they're noise-canceling, and they're only $199. So, you know, they're a very affordable option in the noise-canceling world. So how do they perform? Are they worth the money? And how do they stand up to others in this sort of price range? Well, today I'll find out. As you might expect with a headphone like these, the headband is made of plastic. However, there is a strip of metal for the extenders right here, which kind of adds to its durability a bit. There's also this kind of nice padding. It's coated in a soft pleather material, and it's also really flexible. One notable thing about this headphone that sets it apart from some of the others in this price range is that it doesn't clamp your head super tightly. It's actually really a very comfortable headphone, and I get the sense, I have sort of a smaller head, I get the sense that it would fit people with much larger heads than mine as well. So I think that it's a really, just looking at it, feeling it in your hands, although it is like made of plastic, it is a solid set of headphones. Additionally, the headband actually folds, so these are super portable. The ear cups are a great size. They're pretty manageable. They don't feel super bulky. They feel good on my head. And I like the shape of them overall. I think that one sort of nice feature is that these really give, these ear cups really rock in the yokes pretty well. So it can sort of fit different shaped heads and that sort of thing. And then additionally, the ear cups work via like touch controls. So rather than pressing buttons or trying to feel around for whatever, you can actually change the volume and take calls, play, pause, all of that good stuff just by touching the ear cup itself. Now, just like the padding on the headband, the ear cups are sort of coated in that same soft pleather material. Now, they're not super thick, and there's sort of a lot of space in the middle for your ear to live. That actually comes as kind of a pleasant feeling with these, because your ear isn't really touching the surface. It's not in jeopardy of hitting the actual ear cup. So it makes it, you know, it makes them really comfortable, especially for something in this price range. And if you have big ears and you know, sometimes find that you have a hard time getting, you know, headphones like this to sit comfortably without like touching your ear and stuff, these are gonna be the headphones for you for sure. Now, the Bluetooth connection with these babies is super strong, actually. I was really impressed. I tried to get the thing to break up, and only after walking over 30 feet away and having big structures in between these headphones and my source, which was my phone, only then did the headphones kind of start to break up a little bit. But overall, very impressive connection. It connects over Bluetooth 4.1, so a really solid sound, and yeah, they worked really well. In addition to listening via Bluetooth, you can also listen via a wire. It comes with the audio cable, 3.5 millimeter, so you can use that if the battery dies or anything like that. You can just plug the headphones in. The battery life on these is pretty impressive, actually. If you're using the noise cancellation and you're listening to them wirelessly, you'll get up to 25 hours out of one single charge from these. So yeah, a pretty impressive battery life here. Now, the noise cancellation on these, it wasn't super strong like a Bose or a Sony, but it wasn't super sort of like laid back like a Sennheiser. It really sort of did a great job of really canceling out low frequencies. And it was kind of like a medium strength noise cancellation. It actually felt pretty similar to the JBL noise cancellation. And yeah, I think that it did a really good job of sort of getting rid of that unwanted ambient noise. So I think that these would be really good for an airplane in particular. If you're trying to cancel out voices or something in the high mids, these might not be the best choice, but if you want something that, you know, really cancels out those low frequencies, that kind of underlying hum that is sometimes around in the world, these are going to be the ones for you. Now, the touch controls are on board the left ear cup, and I found that they were very responsive. They worked really well, although something that sort of threw me off guard is that, you know, switching to the next song is actually swiping up and swiping down, which in my head, you know, intuitively, that would be the volume control. Volume is actually tapping up and tapping down. So basically, the thing that I just wanted to stress here is that just look at the instructions first, because it works really well just so long as you know what you're doing. Now, the sound on these, the low end is really nice and strong, robust, as they say. You get a nice kick drum responses, bass synths, bass guitars really have a lot of energy and they really bump. However, this sort of emphasized information down here isn't over the top. It's not like over dramatic in the same way that something like Beats would be. In fact, there's a lot of space for the low mids to sort of live alongside the low end. So you kind of get more detail out of these than you would out of maybe a JBL or a Beats. So there's a nice separation between the low mids too and the rest of the mid-range. However, the rest of the mid-range can get a little bit cloudy. I think that might have something to do with the noise cancellation and sort of the soundstage being a little bit sucked in. However, it's still, you still get like some nice detail with these headphones. The highs are clear and they're not overly emphasized, which I really sort of like. But as a result, cymbals and vocals, for example, you know, they still have air and they still have that sort of like pretty sparkly thing, but it's just a little bit quieter than you might expect with a headphone like this. In conclusion, these headphones are a really awesome option for a wireless noise canceling headphone that won't go crazy on the bank. It's just $199, not $400. Now, the noise canceling on this is really pleasant. It has a good sound. It's a little bit clearer than some of the others in this sort of price range. So I recently, actually yesterday, did a review, a comparison review between these headphones and the JBL E65BT. So if you're curious about that, be sure to stop by Major Hi-Fi. You can see it there. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe. Thanks, everybody, and have a great week. I'll see you next time. Peace.